Great to see you. Welcome to
nice to
the
be here.
Fox Breakfast.
Yes.
It's great to have you here for the end of season one,
yeah.
Season two.
Mm-hmm.
And this year you can actually talk about the show.
Yeah, finally. We've got something to sell, I suppose. Because as you say, last year we were here just, you know, promoting the show. Well, I said promoting, but announcing the show, rather. And so this year we're here to promote it. We've actually got something to show for it.
Mm. No, that's great. And we did, you know, Napoli Comic Con, London
yeah.
Comic Con. We're back in San Diego. This one is a bit special.
Well, this is the mother of all Comic Cons, isn't it? This is the biggie. You know, this is the Wimbledon of Comic Cons. This is the Open Championship of Comic Cons. My sporting analysis. The Champions League of Comic Cons. So yeah, it's good. You know, it's good setting. It always amazes me the amount of people that turn up for this, you know, their enthusiasm for dressing up in layers of latex in sort of 95 degrees of sunshine. Crazy.
Great. And just going to talk a little bit about the show.
Okay.
And episode 7 is premiering tonight
yeah.
in the US and over the weekend internationally. And we've seen a lot of things already, but there's more to come.
Yeah.
What do you think about the dynamic between Cal and the Reverend, and how it has evolved since Ep 1 up to Ep 6?
Yeah, I think it's an interesting dynamic because we've sort of started out seeing the Reverend very much as the believer on his path and his mission. 100% believing in what his purpose and his goal is. And we've seen Kyle from a very non-believing, very negative manner. And as the series has progressed, there's this seismic shift between the two of them. So he's having more purpose about sorting out what's going on. And if anybody's losing his faith and his belief in everything, in himself, it's the Reverend. So, yeah, at this stage, he's quite a broken soul.
Yeah, and Cal had like a lot of doubts at the beginning and was really, you know, being helped by the Reverend. Mm. And we can see, you know, that.
Yeah, they need each other. There's no doubt about that. It's just that question of finding a continuity and finding a balance and, and compromise, I think. And that's what they're struggling to maybe find at the moment because as you see this sort of shift in the opposite directions with them going. So it's about them sort of aligning their forces together and taking it all on. But, you know, it's just they're trying to work out what the hell is going on still. What is happening in this community? You know, it's been decimated by intrigue and possession and God knows what. Nobody's trusting anybody anymore. So, yeah, they're kind of two souls fighting for, you know, sanity almost.
and it feels like they're kind of by themselves as well, and they don't have many allies, and they are...
You've got Reg, the police chief, is the only other one. I think that's certainly from the Reverend's point of view, the only two people that he can speak to now are... Who will sort of listen to him, because everybody else has turned their back on him, is the police chief and Kyle. And if he doesn't have that, then he's deeply screwed. You know, messy.
So season two has just started, the production, and you're back on
yeah.
set.
Next week.
Is the darkness going to keep spreading?
God, yeah. I'm sure it is. I've only read the first two. They're going to get tweaked probably a little bit. It's all good. It's all good. Trust me. Watch this space.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Philip.
Thank you. Cheers, Anton.
Good
thank
to you see guys. You. Yeah,
and, cool.